The blue veil shows the extent of the spell's reach.
But I can feel its ether from here.
Shula, wait. Before we cross the threshold, I'd like to know a little more about how these magics work. I assume we'll be safe from their influence.
We won't grind to a halt, if that's what you mean. The spell only affects the things that were present at the moment it was cast. But if we can enter, that means other things can as well.
Like the ones we saw on the way here.
And worse, probably.
Is this Leviathan's doing?
Well, it certainly wasn't ours. When he realized my ancestors were attempting to cast a spell from here, he made to destroy the temple.
And almost did, by the looks of it.
Good, but they are.
Then why is it so cold in here?
It's over. slow. You're finished.
Would have been a hall of worship. There was something similar in my father's keep. The priests would deliver their sermons from the dais.
Your father?
Get through this.
Ugh.
One last climb, then. The Vare.
Just as I thought.
Jill, does this ether not feel somehow...
familiar, yes. I sensed it the moment we arrived, though I wasn't sure until now. You can feel it too, can't you, Clive? She's calling us.
You don't mean the witch?
I do. Though she was more than that. Much more. She was a dominant. A dominant who once commanded the icon that now resides in both me and Clive.
Of course. I don't know why I didn't see it. Who else would have the power to freeze time?
None other than Shiva herself. For her ether to endure after all these years, it's almost as if... As if she shared it with another. Just as Torgal shared in my ice.
Shiva's companion, though something tells me he's not as friendly as us.
My ancestors never warned us about this.
It wasn't left here for them. I doubt they even knew it existed.
Because it would sooner die than fail its mistress.
Then it leaves us no choice. Nice try.
Chance.
getting angrier by the moment.
Better cut this short.
Okay.
Well, let's destroy it and put an end to this.
Wait. The spell must be weakened, not undone.
Isn't that what we came here for?
Did you ever stop to wonder what might happen to the tidal surge if I unraveled the whole spell at once? I didn't think so. This is going to require a bit more finesse. From wind and light, water and earth, let the silent pall of mine ice. There's too much aether. Here. Let me help. Let us help. Almost!
Oh,
Did it work?
I think so. The thread connecting this place to the child should be broken. Min and Walyas should finally be...
free once more. Leviathan, our most profaned fragment. Its divinity defiled by the hand of man. Its spirit shackled by his hubris. Till Muthos came, bringing release. Now, let the sins of man be redeemed by the hand of the servant of God.
Going on.
Precisely what we feared. Leviathan is out of control.
No.
Don't despair. This isn't over yet. You should head back to the village and get everyone to higher ground. As for the rest, Ifrit will handle. After 8 years of imprisonment, I'd be angry too. But I can't let it end like this, Walyas. It's time for you to come home. Thank you.
All right. I heard you the first time. Then, no more hiding. This isn't what I wanted! I only hope you can forgive me.
Come on.
of Iathan. Stop this! I'm not here to play! the village. Village. I'm not here to play! This has gone on long enough! Play!
Long enough!
the village.
The village.
This! I'm not here to play! Village. to play! Village. To play.
You're just full of surprises, aren't you? Garuda would be proud. Full of surprises, aren't you? Garuda would be proud. You're just full of surprises, aren't you? Garuda will be proud. full of surprises, aren't you? Garuda will be proud.
full of surprises, aren't you? Garuda will be proud. Not this time. If that's what you want.
Now that was quite a tantrum.
Clive! Where is he? Well, yes. He's adorable.
He is now. But did you see him a few moments ago?
Clive, I don't know how to thank you.
It's all right. We should find him a dry blanket, though. Wouldn't want the little monster catching a cold.
There. He's finally asleep.
The poor thing had a long day.
That makes two of us. So, what happens now?
Now? Now, we make things right.
How?
By providing Walyas what he was denied. A place to learn and grow. A family to love and protect him. So that one day, when the wounds in his heart and mind have finally healed, he might decide for himself how he'd like to live the rest of his life. But until then, I'll stay by his side, come what may.
Then he's a lucky boy. And not only because he'll have the best warrior this side of the belt to teach him the battle axe.
She'll do her best.
Shula. The beast that threatened your home is tamed. The empire that threatened your people toppled. Might it not be time to cast off your ancestors' glamour and retake your place in the Twins?
Perhaps. It's not as if we have the crystals to maintain the wall much longer. But are we truly safe? Is the world truly ready to accept us for who we are and what we believe? If I remember rightly, you and yours still choose to remain hidden, do you not?
We do.
Well, your people will always be welcome in Haven, regardless.
As will yours in the Hideaway. We're allies now. If there's anything you need from us, supplies, food, equipment, do not hesitate to ask.
It's kind of you to offer. But we'll manage, just as we always have. Besides, I suspect you'll be needing everything at your disposal if you're going to save the world.
I fear much of it is past saving. The best we can do is strive to turn what's left into a world where we can all live as equals.
A noble endeavor. And there'll be a place in this world for us, will there? For Walyas.
For everyone. I swear it.
Then we shall be waiting. Until the tides bear you back to shore,
Do you think he'll be all right?
Well, yes. Only time will tell. But I can certainly think of worse places to spend one's childhood. The Motes of Water are a fine people, and they will take good care of him.
Up by the Vare, Ultima spoke to me. He called Leviathan his most profaned fragment, and told me to redeem the sins that had laid him low.
Is that so? The sins of Walius's ancestors were grave indeed. To force him to prime at so tender an age.
And to freeze him in time, that he might never know what it was to live.
Yet I doubt either of those crimes was the source of Ultima's displeasure. It was that the Icon's power had been put to another purpose than the one he intended. To him, Leviathan must have seemed an aberration.
Could that be why Ultima made no attempt to lead me to him? The fear that this profaned fragment might corrupt his vessel somehow?
Perhaps. Or perhaps he simply deemed Leviathan surplus to requirements. Having concluded that his vessel might be made to serve his purposes without the full sum of his power.
His purposes? There's no escaping them. Even here. Hidden away in Mysidia, the blessing of the crystals proved nothing but a prison. A prison into which Walius was born. And from which freedom is hard won. If the world doesn't change, if we don't change it, he'll end up suffering the same fate as every dominant who came before him.
Then we must change it.
That we must.
And we shall.